receive it today?
Yes.
Me too. Amen. Let's pray. Father, we thank you for today, Lord, and for the opportunity to gather together as a body. Lord, and right now I speak to our ears that they hear. I speak to our minds that they're clear, that we understand your word and the things that you are trying to speak to us today. We receive it today in Jesus' name. I declare that the seed that is your word be sown today, be watered today, grow and bear fruit in our lives so that we can go change the world for you. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. Well, if you missed it, children in sixth grade and under, you are welcome to be dismissed at this time. So last week, we started the sermon series, Move Your Mountain. And last week we talked about attitude, hashtag attitude, and how we have to have an attitude shift first. First, we have a faith in God. Our scripture passage, which we will read here in a minute, came out of Mark chapter 11. If you want to go ahead and turn there, you're welcome to. Mark chapter 11, verse 20. But we talk about faith in God and not in me. Faith in Him and not in me. Because when I try to move my mountain, guess what happens? I trip and fall. I'm not strong enough. Avalanche. Look out. Bad things happen when I try to move my mountain. But when I allow God to move my mountain, boom. I have faith in Him and I have not faith in myself. The second thing was not doubting in your heart. First, have faith. Number two, do not doubt in your heart. Because when I doubt, when I begin to think about other things, when I begin, I don't know if that's actually going to work, I've lost it. I have to have faith and I have to keep my faith. Because my faith is in God, not in me. Amen? So that's number two, do not doubt in your heart. And number three, believe that you receive. These are the three things in part of our attitude shift that we have that has to take place in order for us to say to that mountain, move, which is what we're going to talk about today. Those are the three things. Have faith in God. Do not doubt in your heart. And believe that you receive what you ask, what you pray. Because our God is a faithful God. He delivers on His word. He delivers on His promises. Amen? These are all attitude shifts. So let's start our countdown today. Okay. All right. Everybody at Mark chapter 11, verse 20. All right, we're going to start there. As they passed by in the morning, they saw the fig tree withered away to its roots. And Peter remembered and said to him, Rabbi, look, the fig tree that you cursed has withered. And Jesus answered them, have faith in God. Truly I say to you, whoever says to this mountain, be taken up and thrown into the sea, and does not doubt in his heart, but believes what he says will come to pass, it will be done for him. Therefore, I tell you, whatever you ask in prayer, believe that you have received it, and it will be yours. Amen? Amen. Last week, we talked about a shift. We talked about a shift in attitude in dealing with our faith. This week, we're going to talk about action. Action. Something that we do. If we look back into verse 23, it says, truly I say to you, whoever says to this mountain, says, speaks, commands, this is an action. An action. We're going to be talking about speaking today. Because speaking, this, I believe that this is so key right here. Because we can have faith in God, but if we never speak to the mountain, if we never command the mountain, it's going to remain. I can have all the faith in the world, but if I never utilize my authority that Jesus has given me to speak to my obstacle and say, no, you move according to His will, then it's going to stay there. Speaking. Action. Somebody once said, I believe it was Billy Epperhart. I really love this. He said that your voice is your address in heaven. Your voice is the key to unlocking and receiving what God has. Because I can think about it all I want, but until I declare it, until I speak it, it doesn't happen. If I just thought about how much I love my wife, but I never told her, what would happen? She might get the idea that maybe I don't actually love her. But I have to speak that to her. I have to tell her. If I told Kitely, if I never said to Kitely what I expected of her, if I never told her, don't do this or do this or what, and I just thought about it and had faith that she was going to do the right thing, would she? Probably not. I don't know if any of you all have kids, but my kids are not that good. I have to speak. There is something that comes with speaking. There is an authority that comes with speaking. There is something that is released when we speak. It is an action, and it requires us to do something. Not just think about it, not just hope about it, but do something. So today, we're going to be looking at speaking. Amen. This is an action. What it is not. Let's look at that verse again. Truly I say to you, whoever explains to me the size and dimensions of this mountain, whoever talks about the color and shape and location of this mountain, doesn't say that, does it? We're not describing our problems. We're not describing the hindrance to God. Maybe it says this. Maybe it says, truly I say to you, whoever tells God about this mountain, God, there's this really big mountain in my way, and you know, I want to do your will. I know you've called me to good things, to great things, but there's this big mountain right here that's kind of in my way. Truly, I say to you, whoever tells me about your mountain, it will move. I don't think that's it either. Truly, I say to you, whoever complains to me about this mountain, yeah, that's not it either. I don't even have to go there. No. What it says is, whoever says to this mountain, whoever speaks to this mountain, whoever commands this mountain. Who are we talking to here? Are we talking to God or are we talking to the mountain? Because the way that I see this, it says, whoever says to this mountain. We are speaking, we have to understand who we're speaking to. Or what we're speaking to. We are speaking to the mountain. We're not saying, God, this is my mountain, move it. We're saying, mountain, move. By the power of God that is in me. Amen? This is part of that shift. We talked last week about shifting. Shifting our attitude about faith. Shifting what we believe. Or what we think we believe. But shifting and having faith in God and not in me. Not about being self-made. It's not about me and what I can do, but it's about having faith in God and what He's already done. Shifting that attitude. And today it's about shifting the attitude of how I'm addressing my mountain. Because I have to address the mountain, not God. I have to speak. Jesus says, speak to the mountain. He's giving us permission. You have permission today to speak to your mountain. Amen. Amen. We tell the mountain to move because of the authority that we have in Christ Jesus. You know, there's an example in Scripture. Let's turn there right now. It's in Luke chapter 7, starting in verse 1. And this example, this guy, he surprised Jesus. Now, it'd be really cool to be the guy that surprised Jesus, that he marveled at. We're about to read a story about a guy who actually did that. Okay? So starting in verse 1, it says, after he had finished all of his sayings in the hearing of the people, he entered Capernaum. Now a centurion who had a servant who was sick and at the point of death. So this is a serious situation, okay? Let's pause for a minute. This is a serious situation. We got a guy who's about to die. Like, this isn't just your typical head cold. This isn't something small. I got my paper cut. This dude's about to die. All right, life and death, real serious stuff, okay? Painting a picture. His servant was sick and at the point of death, who was highly valued by him, the centurion. When the centurion heard about Jesus, he sent to him elders of the Jews, asking him to come and to heal his servant. And when they came to Jesus, they pleaded with him earnestly, saying, "He is worthy to have you do this for him, for he loves our nation, and he is one who built us our synagogue." And Jesus went with them. This is the ESV, English Standard Version. And Jesus went with them. He was not far from his house. When he was not far from the house, the centurion sent friends, saying, "Lord, do not trouble yourself, for I am not worthy to have you come under my roof. Therefore, I did not presume to come to you. But say the word, and let my servant be healed." Say the word, and let my servant be healed. "For I too am a man set under authority, with soldiers under me. And I say to one, 'Go,' and he goes. And I say to another, 'Come,' and he comes. And to my servant, 'Do this,' and he does it." And when Jesus heard these things, he marveled at him. Notice he didn't marvel at him when he said, "Lord, I'm not worthy of you coming to my house." He marveled at him because he understood authority and he had faith. Amen. He marveled at him and, turning to the crowd that followed him, said, "I tell you, not even in Israel have I found such faith." And when those who had been sent returned to the house, they found the servant well. Surprise, surprise. So let's look at this. First off, the centurion had great faith. That's what we've been talking about. We got to have great faith. Our attitude is first got to be faith in God. See, the centurion believed where the power came from. He knew the power was in Jesus. He believed that. And then secondly, he believed in authority. He understood authority. He understood how this worked. He understands that all I have to do is say, "Do this," and it gets done. When a police officer tells me to stop speeding, it gets done. Or else things happen that I don't want to happen. Because he's a person under authority, and I submit to that authority. The centurion understood this, that Jesus was a man of power. And he had faith that his servant would be healed. All he had to do was speak it. He recognized where the power came from, and it only needed to be released via speaking. And he understood how to command, because he was a commander. Amen? You and me, not only does our mindset have to change about faith, but we also have to understand that we have authority. We have to understand that we have the authority and the ability to speak to our mountain and to command it, not by passively asking God, but by actively commanding God's power. Notice, it's God's power, not my power. We actively command His power to move our mountain. And it's actively action speaking. This is part of that mindset shift. Again, we have to understand first our authority before we can actually speak it. If we don't understand our authority, we'll be like the rest of the people who received healing from God. But the centurion was the one that Jesus marveled at because of his great faith. And he understood what authority was. And if you don't understand authority, I want to help you understand today. We have authority. Because this is what Scripture says about you once you've received Christ. First of all, in 2 Corinthians chapter 5, in verse 17, it says, "Therefore, if anyone is in Christ, he is a new creation. The old has passed away, and behold, the new has come." So first off, when you receive Christ, you are now new. You are a new creation. It's no longer old you, the dude that used to do these things, the guy that used to think this way. Now, I'm a completely brand new creation. It doesn't say I'm a refurbished creation. I am a brand new creation. You are a brand new creation when you receive Jesus Christ. Amen? Secondly, in John chapter 1, verses 12 and 13 says, "But to all who did receive him, who believed in his name, he gave the right to become children of God, who were born not of blood, nor of the will of the flesh, nor of man, but of God." So now I'm a new creation, and I have the right to be a child. I am now a child of God. And understanding who I am in him helps me to understand the authority that I have in him. Amen? When you understand who you are, then you understand the authority that you carry. Does that make sense? When I understand that my daddy is a king, I carry myself a little bit differently. Because I walk in authority, knowing that what I say is going to get done because of his authority that he gave me. I now have authority. You now have authority because you're a new creation. You're a child of God. And in Romans chapter 8, verse 16, it says, "The Spirit himself bears witness with our spirit that we are children of God. And if children, then heirs. Heirs of God and co-heirs with Christ." What is an heir? An heir is someone who receives an inheritance from their parents, right? Right. So now if I'm a child of God, you know, when my parents pass away, they have a will. Me and my brother and my sister will all be heirs. We'll be co-heirs. And we will receive the inheritance that they leave behind for us, whether it's a good inheritance or a bad inheritance. Understand that. Because they can leave behind wealth, riches, a house, assets, or they can leave behind debt, liabilities, expenses. Now understand this. Scripture says that when we are children of God, when we receive Christ, we are now co-heirs with Christ, and we are heirs of God. We get to receive our inheritance, which is our Father's. Who is our Father? He's the King. We get what he has. He's not withholding that from us. Please understand, this is where we get authority. When we recognize who we are in Christ, that our DNA has now been supplanted with his DNA, that our mind is no longer the mind of Kaleb, it's the mind of Christ, that now I get to receive the power of the Holy Spirit because I am a child of God. You get to receive today the power of God because you are a child of God. Amen? And when you understand that, this is a mindset shift. You are no longer you. It's no longer I, but Christ that lives in me. You are no longer you. Therefore, now you have authority to speak to your mountain and say, "Move by the power and will of God, my dad." Amen? Amen? Amen. Because see, something changes when we receive Christ. I am no longer plain old Kaleb, right? I'm filled with the Spirit, Kaleb. I'm full of power that raised Christ from the dead, Kaleb. I'm filled with boldness to proclaim the goodness and wonder of my God, Kaleb. And I'm given authority to speak and to command my mountains to move by the power of God, Kaleb. And so are you. Something changes in us when we receive Christ and when we receive the Holy Spirit and we receive that power. Now we get to choose to either walk and operate in that or not. I'm going to tell you today, I know what my choice is. It's like those commercials, okay? You ever seen the DirecTV commercials? I'm Kaleb and I have cable. I'm Kaleb and I have DirecTV. Kaleb with cable is the dude who was weak, who did things on his own, who had no power, who failed, who was a loser. But Kaleb with DirecTV, Kaleb with the King, Kaleb with the Holy Spirit says, "I'm a winner. I'm a child. I have power and I have authority and I can say to this mountain, move. Because Jesus gave me permission to." He said, "Whoever," look, that's your clause. "Whoever says to this mountain," whoever. See, it's easy for us to receive "whoever" in John 3:16. that whoever believes in him will not perish, but have everlasting life. We can receive that. That's easy. So why do we get hung up on whoever says to this mountain, you move? It's the same whoever. Shift. Shift your faith. Shift your mindset. Speak to the mountain. It's going to move. When we receive Christ, we got more than two tickets to paradise. We got so much more than just a ticket to heaven. I want you to understand today, this is part of the package deal. We get this package deal that comes with salvation, that when we say, Lord, I receive you, Holy Spirit, I receive you, you are now Lord of my life. This is more than just, okay, I'm going to heaven, which is great. But there's also power. There's also healing. There's also authority to speak to the dead. There's also authority to lay hands on the sick, to heal the lepers, to speak to my mountain and say, move. 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 And it will move. This is part of the package deal that we receive when we receive Christ and when we receive the Holy Spirit. Amen? When Jesus spoke to his disciples as he was ascending to heaven, he said, you will receive power when the Holy Spirit comes upon you, and you'll be my witnesses to the ends of the earth. See, we receive power so that it's not just so that we can be like all-powerful, big, bad, macho dudes. It's so that we can say, look at the glory that my God receives. This is what he has done. It all points back to Jesus. Everything that we do points back to Jesus. And if we look weak and wimpy, how does that reflect on him? We're not operating in the power that he's given us. And I'll tell you right now, I don't serve a weak, wimpy God. And I'm tired of seeing weak, wimpy Christians. Because that's bearing God's name in vain. Falsely bearing the name of Jesus who walked in power. Peter's shadow healed people. My shadow hasn't healed people. That means I got to shift my mindset because my God doesn't change. Operation error. I've got to have faith in God. I've got to believe that I receive. I've got to not doubt in my mind, not doubt in my heart, but speak, declare, and command because we've been given authority. Jesus gave authority when he said, whoever says, you have authority today. Whoever says to this mountain, move. Move your mountain today with the authority that you have today in Jesus. Understand, we have authority. We release God's power by commanding it using the authority that he gave us. See, it's not our power, it's God's power. We're just releasing it. We're activating it by speaking. We're saying, move, speak, move, activate, move, command, move, move. But we got to speak it. Here's a great way to picture this. I love this. Andrew Womack, this is actually his illustration. But I think it paints a great picture for us to understand the authority that we have and how we command it and operate in it. It's like electricity. The power company generates the power and delivers it to your house. It's not your power, but it is under your control. You don't call the power company and ask them to flip the lights on, because we know that's not going to happen. Hey man, I'm in the bathroom. Can you flip that light on for me? It doesn't work that way. They would literally just hang up, probably laugh and hang up. That's not the way that that works. They won't do that. They generate the power, but it's under my command, right? It's under our command. We have to simply flip the switch on the wall and command the power to work. Does this mean that we're the power source? No. But I can put a light bulb in my mouth. Will it come on? Nope. I'm not the power source. We're not the power source, but we are in control of what that power does. We can plead with the power company all we want, but they won't flip the switch on for you. You have to assume your authority and acknowledge that the power is under your command. See, we've been given this great responsibility and power that is God's power. And I know that we often don't like to assume responsibility. I would rather say, no, you do it. No, you do it, because that means if it doesn't work, then that's on me, right? Our power company, God, always works. His word is true yesterday, today, and forever. He doesn't violate his will. His promises are true. Our God is faithful. He has moved mountains in the past. He will move mountains today, and he will move mountains forevermore, because he's true. Because he said, if you speak, if you command, and if you declare, they'll move. Because it's by my power. Whatever you ask, it's my power. And if we understand that, if we understand that we have the power to command, to be assertive and say, move, then that mountain's going to move because of the authority of Jesus. We're not the power source, but God moves the mountains through us. Amen? His power is what does the moving, and it's activated when we command it to. Just like flipping on the switch in my house, that power is activated when I say on or off. On and off, just like a switch. And when we command it to work according to the will of God, you're going to feel the ground shake, because those mountains are going to move. Amen? So, now that we understand who we are and the authority that we have, here's how we do it. Speak to the mountain and be full of faith. Not speak to God. Not saying, God, I need you to move this mountain again. No, he said, Kaleb, you speak to the mountain. Okay. Speak to the mountain, step one. Be full of faith. Believing that you're going to receive what you pray, what you speak, what you declare. Speak to the mountain and speak life. Confess what God says over your situation. Confess what his word says, that I have life, that I'm dealing with sickness, by his stripes I am healed. See, there's a difference between fact and truth. Facts are this big mountain that's right in front of me. But truth is that the word of God says, move. By his stripes I'm healed. By his stripes I am healed. And I receive that promise. See, one of my favorite scriptures says that we demolish arguments by taking every thought captive and making it obedient to Christ. We make it obedient to Christ, because scripture's not saying, it doesn't say, truly I say to you, whoever ignores this mountain or denies its existence. See, we don't just, oh, I can't see it, la 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 la, there's no mountain here. We acknowledge that there's a mountain, and we speak to it. And we say, no, by my authority in Jesus Christ and by his power, you move. By the word of God that says, I am healed by the stripes of Jesus. Move. I have the mind of Christ. I have the power of the Holy Spirit. And I have authority from my power company, my King, my God. Have faith and don't doubt. Speak and confess what Scripture says, what God says in his word, and speak to release the power of God over the things that you have control over. See, God, Jesus gave us power over this. He gave us control over this. He gave us authority over this. He gave us permission over this. Heal the sick. Cleanse the leper. Raise the dead. We have authority. We can speak. Amen. So, stop asking God to do the things for you that he gave you the authority to do yourself. Worship team, you can go ahead and come back up. I'm going to say that again. Stop asking God to do things for you that he gave you the authority to do yourself. You have authority So let's put this all together. Attitude and action, moving your mountain. There's got to be a shift. There's got to be a shift in our faith from ourself to God. Understanding who He is, and it's by His will and it's by His power that our mountains are going to move. And our faith is in Him and not in me. My faith is not in my circumstance. It's not in the mountain. It's not what I see. That's not what shapes my faith. My faith is shaped by what the Word of God says, that I am an overcomer, that by His stripes I'm healed, that I will never leave you nor forsake you. That's what the Word of God says. And His promises are true. He is faithful. He is faithful. He is faithful. He has done it, and He will do it again and again and again and again, now and forevermore. Now and forevermore. So it doesn't matter what your problem looks like. It doesn't matter what you're walking through. He is faithful. He is faithful. And He is good. And He is powerful. And He gave us authority to speak. So have faith and do not doubt. Believe that you receive what you ask and what you say. And speak and command your mountain to move in Jesus' name. Our God is faithful and He never, ever fails. His promises still stand. He moves mountains. His power is greater. Amen. Amen. Stand with me this morning. We're going to worship God right now. We're going to lift our voice and we're going to sing. And we're going to speak and declare. I want you to speak and declare today. If there's something that's in your life that's a mountain, right now is your opportunity to speak and to declare. We're all in here together. We're all in agreement. And we all believe. And Jesus is here right now. The Holy Spirit is here right now. There is power here today to move your mountain, to break every single chain, every single yoke, everything that holds us back today. There is power to break that today in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Begin to declare it today. Strongholds broken today in Jesus' name. Lives are whole today in Jesus' name. We declare your word today in Jesus' name, God. You are great. Our faith is in you, God, today. Finances align with the word of God. Health align with the word of God. Families align with the word of God today, in Jesus' name. Satan, you have no place in our home, you have no place in our families, and you must flee, in Jesus' name. Every knee bows to Jesus Christ, our Lord, in Jesus' name. We declare it today, in Jesus' name. Freedom, freedom, freedom and liberty. No more bondage, no more chains, no more addictions. Freedom in Jesus' name. Lord, you are faithful. You are faithful and you are good, and we believe in you and we receive you today. We receive what we pray. We believe that you are good to honor your word, and we hold you accountable to that word right now, today, in Jesus' name. Amen. 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 Thank you, God. Thank you, Jesus. We receive it today, God. We receive you today, Father. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Now listen, you shouldn't need prayer today because you just declared it and spoke it over your life.
That's right.
Right? Right? So right now, we're just going to worship God. We're going to praise Him today for the victory that we already have. Amen? Let's worship God.
Walking around. change to come, knowing the battle's won. For you have never failed me yet. Your promise still stands. Great is your faithfulness.
Your faithfulness, faithfulness.
never forget. We will never forget your faithfulness, God. Who you are, you're great. You're great, God. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, man. We serve a great God. I'm telling you, if you can't leave here today changed, then whew, let me smack you a little bit. Because God is good, man. And he's faithful and he is able. So go today believing in your God and speaking to your mountain. You have authority, church. Be blessed today. Go change the world. Amen. If you'd like prophetic ministry, we're going to have our ministers up here as well today. But be blessed. Go change the world. Go move your mountain today. Amen. Amen.